and shoot where the air's nice. And let's risk it all on the paradise. But she just wanna make sure her hair's nice. That's fair, right? I just fell in love with a prima donna, the 2023 Madonna. I mean, your honor, I was minding my business until she gave me complete nirvana.
Are you ready? Okay, say no more. Are you ready? Okay, say no more.
She's a lotus and I'm the conductor of a magnum opus. Simply braggadocious, why don't we take advantage of this moment? And wherever you own, we own it.
Made apple pies, family size. Leather bombers and Nike Sakais. Dangerous corners, you better pray that tomorrow arrives. Rap Sugar Ray Robinson, nothing sweet. Y'all too out of shape to even box with me. Heavyweight, I know my way around the ring. Just like Shorty know a way around a storm. Making hits with Hit Boy, all he gotta do is hit record. Record breaking news, had to show up just to fill a void. Confused, spoiler boys, y'all better keep your poise. Leave me out of the weasel. Be cool when you see me, I'm hot at all that rap deep. The hood know you, so we don't borrow, believe in it. Locked in on the instrumental, I took back the key to this. Run me the keys, run me the bees, run me that float back. In top three, I'm not number one, how could you post that? I wear the crown, the city is mine, you cannot hold that. I'm not the one to go back, meet Joe Black. Run me the keys, run me the bees, run me that float back. What I'm saying, in top three, I'm not number one, how could you post that? I wear the crown, the city is mine, you cannot hold that. I'm not the one to go back. Meet Joe Black. What I'm saying, people saying what's already been said. Predictions, I don't listen, it's already in my head. No funny, your most hungry place. I was past that at 28. Underground tapes, as my ass cap in publishing states. As we slide in the G-Ride, I've been getting criticized. It's keeping me energized. Create with a business mind, I'm from where killers reside. A wild hood, only new goons since my childhood. Say anything in they raps cause it sound good. Don't even mean what they say, horrible outlook. Y'all ain't really about this house. Y'all was in the house with.
Tonight, from Mercedes-Benz Stadium in Atlanta, Georgia, it's the NFC Championship Game. Atlanta Falcons taking on the Detroit Lions.
The NFL playoffs are on EA Sports, and we've got a packed house here at Mercedes-Benz Stadium in downtown Atlanta. Coming up, it's a battle to represent the NFC in this year's Super Bowl, and we've got a classic in store between the Detroit Lions and the Atlanta Falcons. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. The postseason continuing here on EA Sports. And man, it is electric in here, and it should be conference championship time.
I don't know about you, but my butterflies in my stomach, they have iron wings in this one. And every guy I've ever talked to has all said the same thing. This game, the conference championship game, may have more intensity than even the Super Bowl because you know what the stakes are. You're trying so hard to get to the big game. That this is the one that's the real challenge.
So here are the Lions now coming out for their opening drive. And a look here now at their fourth year quarterback.
And we can talk all we want about football being a team game and leaning on different parts and aspects in order to get it done. And that's entirely true during the regular season. Some weeks it's the defense, the special teams, running the football. But in the playoffs, all the pressure reverts to the quarterback, and he has to play well and play at a really high level in order for his team to win.
Out of the gun now on third down. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And he is going to have a Lions first down as he's able to get 8 yards there on third and five.
I think that's a big pickup for a first down, because when you run a drag route against zone, you're sometimes asking for trouble because you might run into a defender.
Yeah, well, there they ran into a first down, executed it to perfection. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Looking to throw. Vaughn, he finds his man, complete. That's Brady. Play fake. Vaughn. And that is incomplete. They come up now third and five following the incomplete pass. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. And he comes back with one complete.
And they'll get this down to around the 47-yard line.
Usually see those guys out wide get called for holding on running plays. Here, a passing play.
Yeah, sometimes we get this quick screen, bubble screen, anything where they're having to block for their fellow receiver.
And the Falcons get there. The Falcons get the sack. Down he goes. It's a loss of 10 on the sack, and it leads to fourth. Tell you what, he did not have much time there to scan the field before he was ducking and covering.
Did it appear to you, as it did to me, that the defensive front won their play really quickly?
Yeah.
Meaning the guys in front of them had almost no chance to block them. They were on him in a hurry.
Here comes the Lions punter now. As the first drive of the game stalls out, he's on to punt. Turn there, call it 13 yards. And out will come the offense as they take over. So here come the Falcons now to get the football for the first time. And trotting out there, their tall quarterback, standing at 6'5".
We're seeing it more and more in this league, how teams love to have athletes back there taking the snaps, guys who can throw it and move around and get yards with their legs if needed. He's one of the best examples that we see out there right now. He can throw for hundreds of yards 1 week and then run for 100-plus the next. He adds an extra dimension that really confounds defenses when he puts it all together.
And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. On first down, Ratliff. And he'll take this ahead for about four. Second down coming up. The run got four. Now they deal with a second and six. Back to throw. Rich. A fight for it, and this is caught. What a catch. It's a gain of 35.
Well, big plays have been a hallmark of this offense all season, so there was no reason to think that it wouldn't continue here in this title game. Obviously, the magnitude of the event, not getting to them early.
So the big play means just like that, they'll operate from the red zone now on first down. Looking to throw. Rich. And this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down.
Well, anytime he reads man coverage, I don't think it's going to be the only time he'll try and hit that route to the outside in this game. He'll test the perimeter, but that time, they were up to the challenge.
To throw again. Rich got his man complete over the middle. It's Jacobs. And the Falcons are going to have a first and goal as he'll be taken down at the 7-yard line. the middle they go. Ratliff. And a little bit of space there. Takes it inside the 5 to the 3. So the ball position now at the 3. Here's second and goal. And that is caught. Touchdown, Falcons. From 3 yards out. And the Falcons have struck first in this NFC title game. Well, we knew they had the crowd on their side. Their defense has already made a stop, but now here's an opening drive touchdown.
Yeah, how about the defense making the stop, offense feeling their momentum that they've generated and turning it into points on their side. So now you've got a team working together, and you've got the crowd involved fully on their side in this ball game.
And in this playoff atmosphere, that 12th man means even more. Point after, right down the middle. And that makes the score 7-0. So that winds up a 7-play drive all told. And the end result, an Atlanta touchdown. Atlanta's 11 ready to go, and they kick it away. And he'll elect not to return this one, so they'll bring it out to the 25 on the touchback. Back onto the field come the Lions for their second overall drive. A last series form, a little disappointing, forced to punt. And now they'll try to do better here and come away with some points as they begin this drive, first and 10. Now a play fake here on first down. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
Well, it certainly appears that they're going to try and keep getting him the football. It's the third time they've looked in his direction. Unfortunately, haven't completed one yet, but I'm not sure they're going to shy away from him. They feel like they've got something there, and they want to capitalize on
it. I think you're right. We're only in the first quarter, so a lot of opportunities ahead. Following the incomplete pass, here they go again, second and 10 from the 25. Now the first carry for Bush. He'll be dropped after a gain of about 6 across the 30 to the 31.
It's not a huge breakaway run, but if your starting running back finishes the game with averages of 5 or 6 yards per touch, you'll take that every single time.
From the gun on third down, Vaughn. And that went a little too high as it's knocked away and incomplete. Here comes the Lions punter now as he'll come on to kick this one away. First kick, 47. This one looks good as well. Fielded at the 20. And that'll be a return of 12 following a very nice punt. So for the second time in this one, we get set to see the Falcons offense. We're just two series in here, Charles, but everything's gone to script so far. They got a touchdown on their first drive. Their defense holds, and now they've got a chance to take a 2-score lead.
And to co-sign with you, exactly the start they scripted up. And really, that kind of start, that can set the tone for the game for them.
Here's a throw, complete right side to start things out. He'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. That one good for 20 on the catch and run.
Well, it's almost as if they didn't leave the field after their first drive. They picked right up where they left off. Another good throw there. And this offense humming here in the early going.
From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. And they nearly sprung him that time as he takes this all the way down to the 37. A good gain again. That's now 31 yards combined on those last two plays. Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. Now a handoff up the middle. Ratliff. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and 4. Off play action. Rich. He'll take a shot for the end zone. And that's going to be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's third down. From the gun on third down, Rich steps away to his left. Throwing left side, it's complete. Touchdown, Falcons! A great effort there. 31 yards. And the Falcons are off to a 13-0 first quarter lead. Another impressive drive, so they're 2 for 2, 2 touchdowns. Charles, a great start to this ball game for them.
And one of the words that's really worked its way into our lexicon is stacking. They've stacked momentum each time out, not only on offense. Between those touchdowns, defense held, forced a punt to get the ball back, and they've played awfully well in this one. Both sides playing at optimum level.
The extra point up and good. And that'll make the score 14-0. 5 plays there on that drive. And the Falcons score to cap it off. Atlanta's 11 ready to go, and they kick it away. Taken at the goal line. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line. Detroit's offense ready to take over. They'll need to come from behind if they want to play in 2 weeks as they trail early in this NFC Championship game. So first and 10 now from the 30. Throwing to start the drive. Vaughn, he finds his man complete. It's Bush. Off the play fake. Vaughn. Throws right side, and that's complete. His first catch in this NFC Championship game, and it's a first down.
That's a pretty throw right there. That ball's in the air a long time, but it's right on the money on the right sideline. A really good route. Moving the defenders towards the middle of the field before breaking to the sideline. What a completion there. Big-time arm strength.
Plenty of shouts from this crowd as they watch the replay. They want a challenge, and they're going to get one. Did he keep those feet in bounds? That's the question they've got to decide. And I got to say, watching it in real time, it was awfully close.
Yeah, certainly looked like a heck of a catch because he didn't appear to bobble it, which could complicate things. But even with the benefit of replay, that's pretty tight.
Well, here's the call. So the challenge there does not go their way. This will indeed remain a completed pass. Bush trying the middle. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to 2nd and 4. Now they'll throw here out of the gun. He finds his man complete. That's Brady. And he's going to be marked down just inside the 35. Throwing on first down, Vaughn. And he's going to get 7 out of this before being taken down at the 27. They run up the middle with Bush. And he'll go down here right around the 23-yard line. First down, they stick with Bush. And he'll get it down this time to the 17.
And hold on here, because on that last run, it looks like we have a player who was shaken up. Hopefully, obviously, nothing serious here. Medical staff, though, going to take a peek, and we'll take a break.
6 yards on that last play. Here's 2nd and 4. To throw. Vaughn throwing middle, and it's complete. And the Lions are going to be set up with a 1st and goal here as the tackle made at the 9. First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. Looking to throw. Vaughn over the middle. It's complete. That'll bring up second and goal after the gain of five. They'll run it with Bush. And he's going to take it in for a Lion touchdown. Taking it in from 4 yards out. And the Lions have cut it back within a score. Well, he finishes off the drive with a touchdown run, Charles. Remember, he also had a catch on this drive as well.
And that's what running backs want to be in today's NFL, a complete back. Three downs, stay on the field, run it and catch it, and he gets it done.
Extra point forthcoming. And that one makes it 14-7. A 10-play drive that time, and it results in a 4-yard touchdown run. This game back within a touchdown now as the kickoff's away. Fielded just outside the goal line. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28. Atlanta now coming out on the field. So for this offense, Charles, remember, drive one made it to the end zone. Drive two resulted in a touchdown as well. Now they'll try to make it 3 for 3.
Yeah, and you know, they told us all week that this was the plan and this is what they wanted to execute, but did they really believe it would happen this well, this efficiently? I know they'll take it, and afterwards they'll say, there's never a doubt in our minds we were going to be successful with this one.
The drive starting play, a good one. Give him 19.
Absolutely love the run right there. This guy's known for his quickness, but also for his speed, and he's able to get to the second level almost before you blink if you give him any type of blocking. Always talk about slot receivers, and they're usually known as quicker than fast. In this case, we've got a guy who's quick and fast, and he used it to great advantage.
A big hitter to start the drive has him up near midfield here for first and 10. Oh, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted. And the Lions are going to take possession of the football. Well, this was a 14-0 game not too long ago. Things were looking pretty good. Then you give up the touchdown on the last drive. Now the interception.
So that's a lesson in trying to stay vigilant, isn't it? You have to stay on top of things. Can't relax too much because, as you noted, things change. Now they've got to go out there and get a spark going again and try and slow down this comeback.
The counter, it's Bush, and he edges forward but only gets a pair of yards out of it, and it's second down. The last run got a couple. Here's second and 8. Here's a toss, Bush to the left, and they go backwards here, losing yardage back at the 48-yard line. They went backwards 7 yards, setting up a tough third down.
You see that celebration from him after that stop? Those corners don't normally have the chance to get behind the line of scrimmage and hand them big losses. So when he got that opportunity, he certainly made it a memorable one.
Throwing on third and long. Vaughn looking left side. It's complete. He's got it. Only able to gain a couple there, and it'll be fourth down. Here comes the Lions punter now. He'll boot it away from about his 35, and he's getting a workout here in this first quarter as he gets it away. And that'll hit at the 5 and go into the end zone for a touchback. The Falcons ready to take over. And we'll see if they can bounce back from that last drive, in particular if they can bounce back at the quarterback position, Charles, after throwing their first interception of the ball game.
Yeah, and some guys, you know, they're going to want to try and get a big play right away and take control back. Others, they're going to look to hit a couple shorter passes and get a little momentum back that way.
But for the defense, that goal's not changing a bit. They want another pick.
You're exactly right about that. In fact, you've got to watch them a little bit because in coverage, they may cut down their gaps a little bit, maybe their splits a little bit in order to try and get to the ball even faster.
Now they face a third down and four after that incompletion on second down. Operating from the gun, Rich. He finds his man, complete. That's Ferguson. Touchdown, Falcons! A big play there, 74 yards. And the Falcons go up by two touchdowns. This stage conference championship game, every play is magnified, and that was a big play.
No doubt about it. One thing that has these guys a step away from a shot at a big game, their big play ability. They can strike from anywhere.
Now the try here for the point after. It's good, and it is now 21-7. Atlanta touchdown. Atlanta's 11 ready to go, and they kick it away. Taking it about the one. And he won't quite make it to the 25. And Detroit getting set to go now. And Charles, a very uninspired effort. The last time we saw them out there was a quick three and out, then they punted the football.
Yeah, and you never want to get stopped so soundly during a series, but what would be even worse now is letting it happen again right here. They've got to get going.
Throwing to start the drive. Vaughn, and that throw behind his man. He missed him, incomplete. From the 24, they'll go again on second and 10. Throwing again, Vaughn. He finds his man, complete. It's Bush, and he's brought down, getting this one up to about the 35. A pretty wild first quarter, 21-7, our score. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. This is Bush, and hard running's going to get him over the 40 to the 42. So they'll come up after the gain of 7 on a 2nd and 3. Back to throw. Vaughn, he finds his man, complete. It's Brady. A gain of 5, good enough for the first down.
There's a completion to the tight end, and I think that we're looking at something out of central casting, frankly.
Absolutely. I mean, size, the hands.
Speed. I mean, can flat out run. You put that whole package together, you light up the eyes of an offensive coordinator, don't you?
And he's over midfield and into Falcon territory. They'll go again with Bush, and this won't be enough to pick up the first. A gain of 2, 3rd and 1. The Lions on 3rd down. They've only converted once in 4 tries. They're up against a 3rd and 1 situation. Quick hitter here, it's complete. And he is going to have a Lions 1st down as they're able to convert by plenty there on 3rd and 1.
Well, this might very well have been 4-down territory, but that's not going to matter now. They get a nice throw there on 3rd down, and they're able to keep the drive going.
They'll hand it off to Bush, and he's going to be hemmed in and brought down right at the line of scrimmage. A Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down.
He may be a bit undersized compared to the modern-day NFL defensive tackle, but what he lacks in size, he definitely makes up for in his ability to make tackles in the run game as well.
Here's second and 10. Looking to throw. Vaughn firing quickly here, and that's complete. And he's going to be taken down at about the 33. From the gun on third down, Vaughn. And a quick throw here, that's complete. Give him 7 yards on the play as they do pick up the third down conversion.
They've been moving the ball well, but this drive was in danger of stalling out. Fortunately, this is a nice throw here, and they're able to pick up a new set of downs.
On first down, Vaughn looking middle, and that's complete. And he'll be marked down right at the 20-yard line.
Now that's often a surprise for the defensive guys when they see the big fella slide out of the backfield and catch the ball. Not something they usually go over in practice very often.
A give. This is Bush. And he'll go down here at the 12-yard line. 46 yards rushing on 12 carries for him now.
Even though they gave up more than they wanted to on that play, it actually illustrates how well they bottled him up throughout the game, because that was his longest run of this contest.
From down at the 12, it's first and 10. Now a first carry for their fullback. Down to the 6-yard line on a pickup of 6 as he gets halfway to the goal line. Second and 4, they could still get a first down without scoring. Operating from the gun, Vaughn. And in for the Lions, touchdown. From 6 yards away. And the Lions are back within a score.
Obviously, Brandon, they couldn't get it all back with just one score, but that touchdown chips into the lead, and now it makes the comeback a little bit more manageable.
A try here for the extra point. It's up and good. This becomes a 21-14 ball game now. That one was an extended drive. 14 plays all told. And the end result, a Detroit touchdown. Here are the Lions now as they line up and kick this one away. And this will not be brought out. It's a touchback. Here comes the Atlanta offense now, ready to take over here.
So both of these teams, Charles, coming off touchdowns now, but this offense, they just had to stand on the sideline, watch their opponent author a really impressive drive to reach the end zone.
Yeah, and I think you're not telling yourself the truth if you don't think there's some one-upsmanship going on right now, because they just had their touchdown answered by a drive of double-digit plays that also found the end zone. Now they want to do something even more impressive to answer that one.
Here's second and 9, just a yard on that last run. They'll try and run with their fullback. And not a whole lot doing there, as he'll get it up to about the 28-yard line. To throw on third down, Rich, caught by Wilson. Down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
I got a kick out of that one, partner. You and I talk often about trying to hide receivers in certain situations, but a guy of his size can't really hide him. But the tight end drag route, definitely an effective way to sneak him across the formation for an easy completion and a first down.
They go play action here on first down. They'll roll him out right. And it's a short one here, complete to his tight end. And they'll get this down to around the 47-yard line.
Sometimes it's design, and sometimes you just have to know when to leave the pocket and move and make something happen. And on that play, he's able to get on the run and was still accurate throwing the football.
So the ball moves into Lion territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 47. Up the middle they go. Ratliff. And not a whole lot of room to operate there on the first down run. He gets maybe three.
Yeah, I don't know if it's exactly a win-win, but if you're on offense, you'll take that kind of a run, all right? It was kind of stacked up, found a little bit of yardage, and frankly, they're pretty close to staying on schedule on offense. The playbook is still open for the coordinator.
And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. 48 yards now on the ground on just seven carries.
Muscle damage has been done through the air. I mean, they've rung the bell three times with passing touchdowns, but guess what? Ground game has not been neglected. Nice little burst right there.
From the 34 now, here's first and 10. They'll keep it on the ground. Ratliff. The last run got three. Now here's second and 7. Now they'll switch it up here and look to throw. Wilson's got it complete. He'll be dropped at the 25 after a gain of 6. Ninth play coming up here on this drive. This is third and a yard. They give it off here to the tight end. And he gets this down to the 18. Good enough for a first down. Give him 6 yards and they do convert on third. And that looked like some pretty easy yardage there right up the gut.
And he's a guy that has some height to him. So when you don't have to drop a shoulder or create or get through contact or trash, makes it a lot easier to stay upright, see the field, and make a run as we just saw there.
So from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18. Back to throw, Rich. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
And when a team advances as far as they did, got over the 50-yard line, don't you think that drive deserved a better ending? I think he needs to get with his coaches on the sidelines, make some immediate adjustments, and that's what you do. You don't wait. You do it from series to series because drives like that, to end with a turnover, that's multiple times they picked him off already in this opening half.
Detroit's offense ready to take over. The offense coming back out here. Plenty of energy, ready to roll, looking to just add to what they have been doing after scoring a touchdown, Charles, their last time out.
And that's a great feeling to have on the sideline, partner, knowing you just won the battle against the opposing defense. And since they came off the field, I'll guarantee you all they want to do is get back out there because they know they have the upper hand on that defense right now. And partner, to me, that one was all about timing. If he's there too early, it's going to be a pass interference call. If he's too late, it's a completed pass. He was Johnny on the spot on that one.
He'll try again with the arm here on second down. Jones has it. They do get a yard there, but only a yard. Leaves him with third and 9 looming. Looking to throw. Vaughn, he finds his man, complete. That's Bush. And he is going to have a Lions first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
But they certainly made a point of getting him involved in the passing game here in the first half. They must have seen something in the scouting that said, hey, we can capitalize on him getting the ball, possibly in the open field. And I think in the second half, that may loosen up the defense a little bit to get the running game going back inside.
From the 32 now, here's first and 10. Again, he'll drop to throw. Throwing middle, and it's complete. That'll go for a gain of 7, and it's second down.
Some think the teams really won't throw a slant route unless you have a receiver that has a lot of stature to him. But sometimes the little guys, they get lost in there. People can't really locate them, and they run that quick cut on the slant, and oftentimes they can turn it into big plays.
They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. And he'll get up to the 43-yard line. A couple of first downs has the football positioned at the 43 as they come up first and 10. And he tries to power forward, but he will not get back to the line of scrimmage. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
Sometimes you read a defense thinking pass rush, and you see them all in those sprinter stances. You think you can give that quick hitter to the fullback and have it go for 7, 8, 9 yards, but not that time. They stuffed it before he could get back to the line of scrimmage.
So after the loss of a yard, they'll look to push forward here on second down and 11. And again, they'll go right back to their fullback. The second down play, not much better than the first, just a gain of 1 there. The Lions on third down. They've hit 4 of 7. This is 3rd and 10. Back to throw. Vaughn. And he's got his man in stride, complete. And he gets it just shy of midfield, but that's not enough. He's short of the marker. Here comes the Lions punter now, as he's on to punt for the 4th time tonight. This is away, but boy, headed straight for the sidelines. No returning this one. It sails out of bounds, and they'll spot it right at the 20. Atlanta now coming out on the field. And 2 interceptions thrown here in this first half. You hear it, no matter the sport, they say the great athletes, they can kind of have a short-term memory, but that's easier said than done.
It is easier said than done, but I played with a guy who threw 2 interceptions in the first quarter of a really big game we were playing.
Johnny Unitas?
And no, not quite of that level and not of that age. But I remember looking over at him, and he was smiling. And I thought, what is he smiling about? It's because he had enough confidence in himself that was a fluke. And he went out and played pretty well the rest of the day.
And he gets this one just shy of the 40, down at the 39.
I like how they worked the tight end on a nice little under route there. And if you're going to give him that much space, he's not going to catch the football. He's going to run away from me a little bit. And that's exactly what he just did there, picking up extra yardage.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a 1st and 10. Looking to throw. Rich, he finds his man, complete. That's Stanley. And they'll get him down on the other side of midfield. To throw again. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Jacobs. The Falcons going to use the 2nd of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over a minute to go before halftime. They'll look to throw again. Throw left side, complete. That's Wilson. And he's going to be taken down at the 28-yard line. On 1st and 10, Rich, he finds his man, complete. That's Stanley. And he'll be taken down at about the 22-yard line.
You don't see too many pass-catching fullbacks nowadays, partner. In fact, you don't see too many fullbacks, period.
Good news, though, he does have decent hands, and we saw it right there on display. Looking to throw on 2nd down. Rich. And this will be caught by his big wide receiver. Now a 1st and 10 at the 11. Back to throw. Rich. Got his tight end. That's complete. It's Wilson. Now a timeout signaled for, and they'll get it with 10 seconds to go before halftime. To throw on 2nd down. Rich eluding the pressure right. His pass caught at the four. Oh, and he's going to be brought down a few yards short of the goal line, and they're going to be unable to stop the clock from here. So close yet so far, and that's going to be how this first half will come to an end.
All right, Brandon, thanks. As always, one half remains in the battle to see who will take home that George Halas Trophy and represent the NFC in the Super Bowl. We'll get back to you guys in just a moment. But first, let's look back to the AFC Championship game held earlier today. And it's the Kansas City Chiefs who are heading to the Super Bowl as they await the winner of this NFC Championship game. So with that, let's get you right back out for the second half, as one of these teams will represent the NFC in the Super Bowl. To find out who, let's turn it back over to Brandon Godden.
Okay, Coach, thanks as always. This one's still anyone's game as we welcome you back for quarter number three.
The Halas Trophy still hangs in the balance as the second half now underway in the NFC Championship game. And out a little across the 25 to the 27. And the Falcons ready to go back to work to start the third quarter. And I think here with the lead, CD, they have to resist that temptation of kind of looking ahead. Would you agree?
Absolutely, I would agree, because they know the stakes. They know the winner of this game goes to the Super Bowl. And this one, it's far from over. They were the better team.
And for a third time tonight, he's intercepted. And he will bring it back. An interception return for a Lions touchdown.
You and I have talked about adjustments so many times during games. Remember, it's really series to series. But coming out after the half, that's a big opportunity, a big time to come out and make one of those plays that can change a game.
Yeah, first play in the third quarter. So offensively, you think of adjustments. But right defensively, maybe you're playing a hunch, you have an adjustment to make.
Yeah, I think sometimes they have that special in there. That, hey, they've run this type of play all in the first half. If you see it, go get it.
Extra point splits the uprights, and we are tied at 21. Nothing separating these two teams on the scoreboard as the kick's away here. This taken in at the goal line. And he'll wind up getting a couple extra yards here for his trouble, and bringing it out of the end zone as he's down at the 27. So out come the Falcons now. They'll start out here with a jet sweep.
That's the way you want to start a drive. Talk about a tone setter as well as a playbook opener. Now if you want to take a big shot over the top, you're all positioned to do so.
And he is going to lose yardage here. It'll go as a loss of a yard, and it'll set up third down.
That was a good illustration of setting the edge as a defensive end, being able to make sure that you stay on your feet no matter what type of block, and you're not going to get pushed inside. Stayed home, skated to the outside, and made the play.
I see an extra defensive back on the field. Little surprise here on third and one. And they'll let their fullback try and push the pile. And that one going nowhere from the start as he's met in the backfield and goes backwards. That'll make it fourth down after a loss of one.
I get the thought process. Third and short, give it to the fullback, let him bulldoze his way. But that means you're counting on your offensive line to win the line of scrimmage, aren't you?
Yeah, there was just a mass of bodies there at the line. Looked like more defenders than offensive guys. Winds up losing yardage.
And on fourth down, on is the punt team sending this one away. And he couldn't get it to check up. That kicks all the way into the end zone for a touchback. Here's the Detroit offense now as they head back out onto the field. The crowd may be losing just a little bit of the edge after back-to-back punts.
They want some big plays. They want to see some offense. They want to see somebody break away, whether it's through the air or on the ground. Now it'll be interesting to see where the patience is on both sides. Each head coach, can you hang in there and not try and force something that could put your team in some jeopardy?
From the 26, they'll line up on second and four. Oh, he'll want that one back. Incomplete. He doesn't drop too many in that department. Third down. From the gun on third down, Vaughn. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. And he is going to have a Lions first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Throwing on first down, Vaughn. He finds his man, complete. That's Bush. And he'll be out of bounds after getting this one across the 40.
I like the thought process, I like the design, but I think he may have waited a little too long to spot his man, because if you're gonna run that drag route, you've got to put it on him and let him turn upfield. Instead, he waits until his receiver's too close to the sideline and they don't get the yards after the catch.
Looking to throw on second down, Vaughn. And that is going to be incomplete as he led him a bit too much. They head to the line facing a third and seven following the incompletion on second down. Looking to throw, Vaughn. Wide open receiver complete. And that's going to be good for another first down as the tackle's made at the Falcons' 38-yard line. Gone to their fullback quite a bit. He'll get it again. He'll be hit down at the 33, 5 yards on the play.
And there's the pickup you want on first down. All offenses say, you get me four on first down, we'll take it. How about if you get five? They'll really be happy.
To throw on second down, Vaughn. And that's going to be good for another first down as the tackle's made at the Falcons' 22-yard line. Give him 12 yards on that one. It earns him a fresh set of downs. They'll run it here. This is their fullback getting the carry. And he is swallowed up right at the line of scrimmage. Bush. And a couple of yards as they move it from the 21 to the 19.
Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
A field goal would get them the lead, but that's not what they're shooting for as they come up on third down. Operating from the gun, Vaughn. Over the middle, it's complete. And the Lions are going to have first and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points.
And that could be one of those turning point plays in a ball game. A field goal gets you the lead here, but they want to make a statement and get 6 points. And they're certainly going to get that opportunity as they get the conversion and set up first and goal.
So another third down conversion, and now they've got a first and goal. On the give, this is their fullback. And he will maneuver his way down to about the 7. The line of scrimmage, the 7 now on 2nd and goal. Back to throw. Vaughn. Oh, that's into a sea of bodies, and it's intercepted. Defenders giving chase, but I don't think they're going to get there. He's at the 30. 10. And he takes this one back into the end zone, and the Falcon defense has a touchdown. So what a turn of events there. You're driving to take the lead in this third quarter, but then one mistake, and you're watching the ball being returned for a touchdown.
Certainly a great example of how focus has to be there on every play, doesn't it, partner? You can't get complacent, and I think that he did. He's got him moving downfield, but that's a play where you just shouldn't have thrown the football, and it ultimately could wind up costing him the ball game.
Extra point right down the middle, and they will take a 7-point lead. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away. And he'll elect not to return this one, so they'll bring it out to the 25 on the touchback. Here's the Lion offense now as they get ready to take over.
The last time, everything looked pretty good except that final play on the pick six. And now they've got to come right back out here, Charles, and try to pick up the pieces and get things going again.
Yeah, certainly seems dire, doesn't it? But there is a silver lining, and it is hard to see so soon after that touchdown. But the game plan was definitely working. They were generating offense, had the ball beyond midfield, getting wins on each down against the defense. So they're moving it well. They just have to hang on to it.
Yeah, as you said, though, probably tough to remember those good things on that last drive when it ended like it did.
These guys have punted 4 times already, and they're staring at a 5th, barring a conversion here on 3rd down. Looking to throw. Vaughn. Quick hitter here. It's complete. And he gets this up across the 35 before he's out of bounds. A give to the fullback on the dive. And he stopped immediately there. No gain on the play there. 2nd down. Back to throw. Vaughn firing quickly here, and that's complete. And that'll be good for 8 yards to the 45. And now a carry here for their fullback. And he is going to have a Lions first down by about a yard as they're able to convert on 3rd and 2.
It's amazing how much advice defensive players get on 3rd down. You hear the bench screaming out, watch the draw, watch the screen, watch the pass here. Very rarely do they reference watching the fullback, and he slipped through and picked up a 1st down.
Two 1st downs have him up near midfield now on 1st and 10. Looking to throw. Vaughn. And a quick throw here. That's complete. And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds. Now Bush running left. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. In search of 6 yards here on 3rd down. This is now the 9th play of the drive. Back to throw. Vaughn. Complete to Jones. And that's going to be good for another 1st down as the tackle's made at the Falcons 37. It's a gain of 11 yards that time, and it produces a new set of downs. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on 1st and 10. Looking to throw. Vaughn. Quick hitter here. It's complete. And he'll be brought down at the 27. Does that motor complete to number 40? It's a gain of 10. First down, from the shotgun now. Here's an inside give. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.